So we're back live now on What You Put In. And, you know, let's get started with our lesson today.
Yeah.
Let's talk about hope. Now, Tara is going to take us through this lesson on hope because I got to be honest, she's the queen of hope. She is the queen of hope. She brings hope into my life. She brings hope into a lot of people's lives. She's teaching now, and I know that her students in Natick are seeing her face on their Google Meet, and it brings hope to their life.
I hope so.
For those that know her,
it's not eliciting other feelings.
If you agree with me, just throw a little reaction of a heart in there that Tara is the type of person that brings joy and hope to people's lives. It's just who she is. So she is going to lead our lesson tonight. I'm so excited. And then we'll talk about some techniques. Yeah, see, look. Awesome. You're getting the heart. You're getting the reaction heart. So you bring hope to people.
Well, now I'm all embarrassed.
But it's true. All right. So without further ado, the one and only
Sophia.
Coach Tara.
Sophia is actually my student.
Yeah, and you bring hope to her life.
Thanks, Sophia. So today we're going to talk about hope. The lesson is pretty short and sweet, to be honest. I like to keep things pretty brief. Evren's my man for dragging things out, so I got to balance them. So short and sweet, this lesson on hope brings me back to my wilderness first responder training. And we were talking about how when you're lost in the woods, and we actually talked about this, I believe, in our first segment when I was talking about positive mental attitude. And my instructor gave us this great, whenever you do this wilderness training stuff, they always give you the rule of threes. So you might have heard the rule of threes where you won't last in the lost in the woods. You won't last 3 minutes without air, 3 days without water, or 3 weeks without food. And my instructor said, and I'm going to add one more, and that's that you won't last 3 seconds without hope. And that just really resonated with me because it's so right. You won't last 3 seconds without hope. You won't last 2 seconds without hope. Because if you have no hope for what's to come, then why even do the next thing, you know?
I think of it as if you don't have hope, then you don't have any fuel for those actions.
Exactly. And I know we're not currently lost in the wilderness, but I think a lot of us are pretty lost at this point, and we're just lost in our day-to-day routine, and we're lost in what the heck's going to happen next. We're lost with all the information that's being given to us, retracted, given back to us, changed. The school closure has been moved back a bunch of times. Like, when is it going to open again? We have no idea. So I think we're all feeling a little bit lost. And so we want to bring up the hope because, like we said, you won't last 3 seconds without hope no matter where you are.
I think of hope, and Tara gives it to me all the time. I just think it's like you've got actions that you can take. You can breathe. You can drink water. You can eat food. But you won't do any of those things if you don't have hope that you're going to get rescued out in the wilderness. Mm-hmm. And so it's your fuel, man. It fuels your actions. It fuels you to take action. Mm-hmm. And I think it's a powerful force. And anyone that's a Star Wars fan out there, as Tara and I are huge Star Wars fans, the entire force comes from hope. Mm-hmm. That's like the energy of the force is hope. And I love that.
I'm just reading. See you tomorrow, Sophia. I'll see you tomorrow. I'm very excited. It looks like the video might be pausing on some people. So if that is happening, we apologize. Hopefully we can download this and it works afterwards.
Yes.
So you might be able to watch. I know it's not live, but hopefully you can watch it after. Seems to be a little bit of technical difficulties this evening. So
yeah.
I apologize for that.
Wi-Fi has been wonky. It's like everyone in the world is on Wi-Fi and all of a sudden it's super slow and sluggish and it's crazy. Like the simplest things of writing emails just takes a little bit longer. So maybe we should do what you put in on patience. So with that, we're going to talk about some techniques tonight. Yeah, and she would teach that one too, not this guy. So we're going to give you some techniques on how to develop hope. And what I love about these techniques, they're easy to do. They require your journal. You've got to do a little reflection. That's part of like being an empowered human, is just continually self-reflecting on who you are, where you're going, and who you want to be. So here we got some techniques for you tonight. And the first one is, in your daily reflection, you should write about two things in your daily reflection. And when you're journaling, if you do these two things at the end of every day, like in the morning, if you want to wake up and take literally 5 to 10 seconds to write down 1 to 3 gratitudes, that's a great way to start your journaling for the day. And if you end your journaling with these two prompts, you are going to be crushing your life and your self-reflection. Mm-hmm. The first thing you write down is, what went well today? What was good about today? We're not talking paragraphs. Like, people are so afraid of getting into a journaling practice because they think it's going to take them years to, like, get every thought in their head down. No, we're talking a few minutes. So what was good about today? And the second thing that you write about after that sentence is, what do you want to do better tomorrow? Or what can you do better tomorrow? So why those two things are good for hope. When you reflect on what went well today, that triggers your brain into automatically seeing the good and what is happening in your favor, which is a fuel source for hope. The second one, when you write about something that you want to do better in your life tomorrow, it gives you something to look forward to. So it's a good way to reflect on, look, I didn't do this real well today. Maybe you wanted to wake up at 7, you woke up at 8. Tomorrow, be like, all right, I want to get out of bed at 7 tomorrow. That's going to be my improvement. That's what I'm going to do that's better. And when you do that, it gives you something that you can look forward to trying to achieve in the future, which that's a fuel for hope as well, something to look forward to. Second technique, positive contribution. When you give hope to others, hope comes back to you. So if you want to build a more hopeful affect and attitude, make a positive contribution to someone else's life. Send them a message. Send them a text. Send somebody some little words of wisdom or hope to others. Tara gave me a bunch of hope today. She's like, look, we're going to get through this. Everything's going to return back to our thriving life. And I needed to hear those words. And I bet by her telling it to me, it probably helped her too.
It definitely did, yeah.
So go make a positive contribution to give hope to others. That's going to increase your hope. The final technique for increasing hope is, we will get through this because statements. When you are feeling like you have no hope and the world is closing in on you, talk about this statement out loud with someone, or just to yourself in the places that you think best, wherever that may be, your bedroom, the shower, whatever it is. That's where I do my best thinking.
Great thoughts in the shower.
Great thoughts in the shower. And this is a great statement to finish. We will get through this because, and then finish that. Because why? Because we have a strong connection, because we love each other, because we know that we believe in humans. We know that we have great healthcare workers out there. We know that we have awesome science that's happening. We know we're going to get through this because, and you finish that off with whatever it could be. And when you start to think and use these phrases out loud, you're going to be focusing on what could happen that's good instead of just focusing on what could happen that's bad and negative. Three simple techniques, really good ones for you. We hope you try a couple of these tonight, especially that first journaling one, and send a positive contribution to someone. And with that, I think we got a great start thought for everybody. So here we go. Start thought. If you're writing them down and keeping track in your journal, start thought. The best views come after the hardest climbs. It's a good one.
And it's so true.
And it's so true. The best views come after the hardest climbs.
Best views come after the hardest climbs. So we hang in there. We hang in there. We keep hiking. We keep getting there. Keep getting to the top. We'll get there. And we will be rewarded.
We will. We're going to get stronger because of this. There's no question. We're going to get stronger. It's going to be hard. We're facing a lot of uncertainty. There's a lot of scariness out there and a lot of fear, and I watch the news and I watch CNN and I'm like, it makes my brain explode. And we're keeping our loved ones close, but also, you know what, this is going to make us stronger as a people, as a society, as a humanity. We're going to grow, we're going to learn, and I guarantee you, I believe, and I'm giving you my positive contribution tonight because I think I need it too. we're going to get through this and the world's going to be a better place because of it when it's all said and done somehow, some way, even though we're going to end up facing a lot of tragedy and a lot of hardship along the way, the climb is going to make us stronger. Mm-hmm. And I believe that. I'm hopeful for that.
Same. Hold on to that hope.
Reminds me of a little story that I'd like to finish off with.
Oh, all right. Story time.
I think also a good thing to latch on to gain more hope in life is to go back and reflect on your past successes. And it brings me back to 2018 DSGS girls soccer. And I'm going to tell a little story. We were coaching the girls soccer team at Dover Sherborne High School. Shout out to DSGS. And we were one game below 500 with one game left in this regular season. You need to be at 500 to get into the state tournament, to be eligible for the state tournament. We were one game below 500 with one game left. We had to win our final game of the season in order to continue the season and get into the state tournament. And if we tied or lost that game, season over.
Done.
That's it. We pack up and go home. Bye. See you next year.
Hang up your cleats.
And we were playing our rival Medfield, and we were playing them at their place, under the lights, on their senior night. Mm-hmm. And they're all pumped up, and they're a great team, well coached, much respect for Medfield, but they're a tough opponent. And so we're going in there, and I think the first time we played them, we didn't do so well. So we're like, man, all right, well, what can you can't go in there hanging your head. You got to go in there with hope. And I remember with 17 minutes left in the game, we were down by 2 goals. It was 2-0 with 17 minutes left. For those that know the game of soccer, you know that it's hard to score goals in the game of soccer.
Yeah.
And I remember multiple of our players, one of them named Hope. One of them named Hope.
Oh, shit.
It was like, we've got this. Come on. We can do this. We can score 3 goals in 17 minutes. And that was infectious, this team. And it was getting to us, and we're like, yes, we got this. 3 goals in 17 minutes. And sure enough, we scored one. And then 5 minutes later, we scored two, and we tied it up with like 9 minutes left. And with 5 minutes left in the game, we scored again to go up 3-2. And that is how the score ended. We won that game 3-2, final whistle. We got into the tournament. We ended up going all the way to the sectional semifinals, which I believe was an incredible run that year, which set us up for this past season where we won the sectional championship and went to the state semifinals, one of the final four teams in the state. And man, that was that moment of hope where we were like, we're not going to just lay down here and die. We're going to fight, and we're going to get 3 goals in the final 17 minutes. So a story of inspiration, a story of hope to get us through. Makes me feel good tonight. So with that, we're going to give our emoji send-off.
Ooh, our emoji send-off this evening is to send us an emoji of something bright.
Something bright.
Scroll through.
Find an emoji that represends
something bright. Find that little bright spot in your life.
Or in your emoji menu.
If
there was an emoji of Tara, I would just post that one. Because she is a bright light in my life.
That's really nice of you to say.
It's just the truth. It's nothing but the truth for our students and what you put in.
Hatching.
Oh, a little hatching chick.
It's a chick.
I
like
love
bird.
It.
It's not a bird.
I love all the stars.
The stars.
Becca G, 2020, a bunch of stars. Emma Lily, some twinkle little stars in the sky.
Caden's
putting in
eyes,
some big old bright eyes and a little, some heart.
Star face eyes.
Some heart face. Eyes. I love it. Little heart eyes. A little cat. You know who I think this is, by the way? I think that is my aunt.
Really?
I think that is my aunt. She is not of a profile picture, but I think KJMKOLO is my aunt who lives in Florida. Welcome to What You Put In. We love you so much. Lexi Levine put in
a little person. I see a person.
A little person, Lexi. I like it. Veronica.
Oh, I think is it a doctor or a nurse?
Is it a doctor? Is it a healthcare worker, Lexi? Veronica put
because
this.
Because that is certainly a
bright
dancer
spot
in all of our lives.
I love that.
Mom, star.
Big star. Big star. Gotta keep the bright lights going to get your hope on. So thank you all for tuning in to another class of what you put in. Spread the word. We are going to be back on Friday night. Now, here's the thing. A lot of people have been telling us Fridays are terrible for social media. Like, no one uses social media on Fridays. We're going to be here on Friday night, 7 o'clock.
Yeah. Because I think a lot of things have changed, though.
I think things have changed. And I know...
What else are you going to do on Friday night? Because you ain't going out.
We're
going
to be back.
You're staying home.
But we're going to announce what we're going to do. We're going to have a special show tomorrow night. Special show. You'll see it on our Instagram channel. So check tomorrow for updates on what the special show will be. And we're running this thing, whether one person, two people show up, we're going to be here. What you put in tomorrow night, Friday, 7 p.m. So pumped for it. And with that, 1,000 bonus points to give away.
1,000 bonus points.
1,000 bonus points.
A doctor. It was a doctor.
It is a doctor.
That is a bright spot.
1,000 bonus points tonight. Right, if you're keeping track, rack them up. You're going to be able to totally redeem these for absolutely nothing in the future except your own personal pride. But maybe these bonus points give you hope.
Mm-hmm.
On the count of three.
And if you don't get it tonight, there is hope that you get it next time.
You might. And there's a lag and it's so weird. One, two, three.
What you put in is...
And as you're typing, know that we are going to do a dance party tonight at the end of What You Put In. So wherever you are, we're going to put on some music. We're dancing. You dance in your living room. Make it look crazy. We're spontaneously dancing. We need it in life right now. We're going to end What You Put In with a dance party.
Let's make it real weird.
And there it is. What you put...
What you put out.
I'm going to give it to him.
Yeah, I'll give it to him.
You know, we're going to give it to him. EDWED... Annie, you got it. Whoever that was, you won it. What you put out. What you put in is what you get out. That is a winner.
I love it.
A lot of second places tonight. A lot of first losers.
I was going to say, Emma Lily was the first one to come in with the completely correct statement.
Yeah, yeah.
What you get out.
She's great. A lot of people doing great. And you probably all put it in, but man, who knows? This is great. Great to see you all. What you put in, that's what it's all about.
Okay, autocorrect. Totally fair. I retract my statement.
Yes, see, the winner. The winner.
Ed Weds Annie is the winner.
1,000 bonus points.
We have to go into the program.
Wherever you are, in your bedroom, in your living room, in your kitchen, get your groove on. We're going to spend some time in our own personal little spontaneous dance party through What You Put In Instagram Live. And I'm going to show you some of my new moves. Here we go.
Yes.
Have a great, great night. We'll see you tomorrow night.
Have a fabulous Thursday evening.
There we go.
Woo! Whoa.
Are you dancing at home? I hope you are standing up and making a fool out of yourself wherever you are at home right now, because we are. Can I show my new dance move?
Yeah.
Will you hold it?
Yeah.
Okay, here's my new dance move. I showed you drive the little car. This is called... No, thank you. I've had enough.
And on that note, good evening, good night,
goodbye, good evening.
I feel like it's a welcome.
Goodbye. See you tomorrow night. Woo!